Just a few days ago, more than 150 people reported feeling a small earthquake in Albuquerque, but imagine if that shaking continued. For days, scientists around the world recorded the ground shaking without knowing the cause. Corey Howard found the answer came with help from a lab right here in Albuquerque.
Near Kirkland Air Force Base, at the base of the Sandias, you'll find the United States Geological Survey Lab that monitors the world. In September of 2023, their instruments measured a vibration that lasted for 9 days.
We had colleagues in Europe that noticed a mysterious long period signal. So the Earth is going up and down about once every 100 seconds or so, and only at that frequency.
Dr. Robert Anthony and his colleagues also picked up the signal.
Usually when you have earthquakes, you get a broad range of frequencies. This was quite unusual.
They tracked it to Greenland, where a massive landslide from the tall cliffs along a fjord triggered a massive tsunami with an initial wave more than 650 feet tall, one of the tallest in history. It heavily damaged an island research station 43 miles away, but thankfully, no cruise ships were in the area at the time, and no one was hurt.
Through seismic observations and modeling, we were able to show that this weird signal was generated by almost like a bathtub effect called a seiche, of water oscillating back and forth in that fjord in response to the landslide.
The water sloshing creating a seiche, a relative of a tsunami where water trapped in a basin, like a lake or inland sea, created repeated damaging waves.
And this seiche mechanism causes a very distinct radiation pattern that you can only monitor with very well-installed equipment that we run out of this lab.
The international team learned a melting glacier was the trigger, as it receded and no longer supported the rock wall, allowing it to collapse.
So we're entering a new paradigm with climate change where we haven't seen things like this before and we don't know what we're going to see in the future.
Reporting in Albuquerque, Corey Howard, KOAT, Action 7 News.
Researchers say events like this one highlight the need to monitor seismic events in remote parts of the world. As glaciers recede and humans move farther north in search of mining and tourism opportunities, the risk they think is only going to increase.